3月10日，佛罗里达州州长罗恩·德桑蒂斯首次访问了提前提名的爱荷华州，因为他正在试水总统竞选，在前总统特朗普计划在那里访问前几天来到该州。爱荷华州对德桑蒂斯来说尤其重要，预计他将在春季晚些时候参加2024年的白宫竞选。该州将于明年初举行第一次共和党提名竞赛，如果获胜，将表明德桑蒂斯是对抗特朗普的可行候选人。正在竞选共和党总统候选人提名的特朗普，由于此前两次竞选总统，在该州享有很高的人气，拥有较大的组织优势。在爱荷华州达文波特的一家赌场，德桑蒂斯向欢迎的人群致辞，他宣传自己在佛罗里达州的政策记录，并在犯罪、移民和新冠疫情等问题上抨击民主党拜登政府。
And I'm just proud to say that when during COVID the world lost its mind, when common sense suddenly became an uncommon virtue, the state of Florida stood as a refuge of sanity. We were a citadel of freedom for people all over this country and even around the world that would come. We refused to let our state descend into some type of Faucian dystopia where people's livelihoods were destroyed and their freedoms were curtailed. No, we chose freedom over Fauciism, just like Iowa, and we were right and they were wrong. But because woke ideology has infected so many institutions, if you really want to protect the freedom of your folks, you got to be willing to defend them against the left imposing their pathologies on your people in any of these institutions. So we've got to fight if we see it in medicine or the universities or the corporations. You can't just say let it go, because then we're going to be living under an oppressive wokeocracy, and we can't that happen. So we say very clearly in the state of Florida, we will fight the woke in the legislature, we will fight the woke in education, we will fight the woke in the businesses. We will never ever surrender to the woke mob. Our state is where woke goes to die.
德桑蒂斯没有公开表示他正在计划竞选总统，但爱荷华州之行是他最近几周在全国各地举办的一系列活动的一部分，因为他正在建立自己的国家形象并吸引财力雄厚的捐助者。3月10日公布的民意调查显示，爱荷华州共和党人对特朗普的支持率下降。在2021年的一项民意调查中，表示他们肯定会在明年大选中投票给特朗普的共和党人的人数从 69% 的高位下降到 47%。